Ethan Carter, I didn't know. But he knew who I was. When the police won't help you and the priests don't believe you, you call on Paul Prospero. You call on me. If you're a kid like Ethan, you're right. Plenty do. Ethan's letter started out just like any other fan mail. But soon there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to hide from me. Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. Already I knew that. No trains had been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow. I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves, and we blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name a thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
Thank you. You can feel it, right? Something, something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it. Ethan disturbed the sleeper. He must be punished.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing! I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him. Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not. Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on. You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy. You've all gone crazy.
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind.
Yeah.